Hello, it's Jonius here, and this guide will be on how to install and use my Steam library tweaks, as well as themes. Firstly, download Steam Friends Patcher from Phantom Gamer's Steam Friends Patcher GitHub page. Then, go to my repository at Jonius 7 SteamUI-OldGlory and download the latest release here. Additionally, if you want to change the blurred game images like this, there's a tool called Steam Machine Covers Downloader, and I have a build on my own version of the Missing Covers Downloader, which has a release here, and you can download this exe. Once you have got the files downloaded, which I've put in this folder for demonstration, go ahead and extract the zip files to their own folder. Open up Steam Friends Patcher. It will patch some files in the Steam directory. Check to see if the library is patched. You'll know if it's patched if you go into the Steam UI folder under Steam, and you can see libraryroot.custom.css and libraryroot.original.css. Once you have checked that, let's go to our application now in the Steam UI Old Glory folder and open up the exe. So by default, just the first option is selected, the install CSS tweaks. And so you'll see this will do a lot for the library already once you press install. So you've got the compact game list and the home and search buttons. Then you go to the game page and you can see the more compact layout with the smaller header size and swapped columns. So now, there's a couple of layout options you can choose from. If you click between each of these links, you can see what the option looks like. So you can pull the play button up to the top here. So we'll try this. Now the only thing is that you may have to manually adjust the logo position by right-clicking and adjust logo position. Then the next option for CSS only, you have the library themes. So the application comes with three library themes you can choose for now. You've got Sheena's Steam Library, which is like a dark black and purple theme. You have Spikeball Dooms, which is more simple, just a black scene theme with the black sidebar. And then you have Acrylic Theme, which is based on a concept from Elite Skyloop, a faded blue and bright blue theme. So after you selected a theme, click the checkbox and install. So now I want to go into another CSS option, which is highly requested, which is the what's new. So the default is top of page. And as you can see, if you just install that option selected, you can see that what's new at the top of the page. I personally like to have it at the bottom of the page because most of the time you don't need to see it. And then if you go to the bottom, you can view what's new this way. And sometimes I do find these things useful. Like I can just click on it and then you can see the news article. And then if you just don't want to see it at all, you can just hide it entirely. So that's also an option. How to get rid of these blurred images. So what you want to do is you want to open up Missing Cover Downloader. So this will go ahead and it will go through your library and download images from SteamGrid DB automatically. ThinGridDB is a website that hosts like lots of user submitted game images, as you can see here. A whole load of them. Okay, so after a Steam restart, it got all the images correctly. So now we'll talk about the options that require JavaScript as well as CSS. Up to now, I've just been talking about the CSS options, which are more simple appearance customizations. So you can choose to have a vertical navigation bar. We'll try with just that. So the first time you install a JavaScript tweak, it will take a little while as it is grabbing the original JavaScript and then converting it. So once you've got that done, you've got the vertical nav bar like this. And then you can also choose to have this with the play button box enabled as well. So here is the classic option layout with the play button in a box and the main content being 85% of the whole page. The news and friends activity is at the bottom of the page in its own frame. Now, as you can see, we have another option called landscape game images. So this is basically, you want to use those long images from old Steam. You want to use them as to display your game library because portrait images are kind of eh. So let's go with this. All right, so you got your landscape game images here. Now they're a bit small. So this is where I go into the JS options. Well, now you've got the main option here, change game grid image sizes. And the default widths are corresponding to the three sizes in the Steam options. Small, medium, large is small, medium, large. So let's change it to something that's more suitable for landscape images. Let's say it's like 160 and we're on small. So install, and there you go. You got your landscape game images. Alrighty, so let's go through the rest of these options, shall we? Now that we've enabled JavaScript options. The setting here for the hover overlay position is basically this game hover image here, the game hover text at the bottom of the screen here, as you can see here. So if you're using JavaScript, let's do it to unset instead of zero. This is like one of the only things you might need to manually change. The general thing here is if you change something here with the configurable variables, as you can see this whole section, you want to reload config. So reload and then install. And there you go, you've got your hover right on top of the game entry text. Increased number of screenshots and DLC displayed. So that's basically if you go to a game page, default, it only shows you 6 DLC pictures and 4 screenshots. So you can increase this up to 12 DLC and 8. Then you got DLC manager row height. This is basically this DLC manager. By default, you can only see 5 DLC at a time on the screen. So this basically reduces the row height. So you can see 12, making it much easier to manage DLC this way. Then you've got your scrolling tweak. If you don't have what's new at the top, it has the add shelf button. What the scrolling tweak is it automatically sets the page past at the add shelf button so you don't see it. If you're using what's new at the top of the page, then you want to turn this off because it will just like cut off the top bit of the what's new a little bit. Vertical nav bar, usually don't have to change this. The landscape image JS tricks, that's also applied to automatically changed with this option. You don't have to change it here. Stop what's new events from loading. If your what's new is like totally bloated and lagging with full on events and whatever advertising and hiding it in the CSS is not enough for you, then you may want to use this option. With this JavaScript tweak, it just won't display at all and it won't load in the background. And then the final option is buggy. It may improve the performance of the scrolling if you're having trouble scrolling up and down, but if you scroll to the top, some of the images will be missing. So that is still buggy. So now in general use of this GUI app, if you find something's not applying, usually unticking and ticking it again and then just pressing install again should work in most cases. if something does go wrong, we need to reset something, there are two options here. So now the first one, Remake JS. Whenever there is a Steam update, which is like, let's say one every few months, say a new version and the JavaScript slightly different, you want to remake JS. So what happens is it deletes the local copy that you have created in the folder, which is here, and then it remakes the JS from the original Steam directory. So basically just refreshes it. Then you got the reset button. So this basically removes all the custom JS modifying stuff I said is plus the CSS custom files from the Steam directory. It doesn't remove it from your local directory. You keep your copies. Keep your copies that you've changed and stuff in your folder. It just removes the stuff in the Steam UI folder to get a fresh working state, just in case anything like breaks or you just want to redo something or configure something. Now, here are some extra things. If you're not using JavaScript at all, you just want to change this to 24:16 so that it will match the default stuff. And then say, oh, you also want to change this to 0 if you're using CSS only, so that the hover position won't just go out of whack like this. Like, as you can see, it just goes out of whack. So once you modify this file, just go reload config install. It does install CSS, and then you've got it at the bottom. So as I said, if you want it like dynamic, you want it right on the game entry list, you need to use JavaScript. So there you go. You've got your library themes, you've got your library appearance and layout, you know, improvements and tweaks. You've got themes, if you like this theme. For the main part, all this stuff is already set, so if you're watching this in the future, most of the stuff should be the same. If you've watched this video to the end, thank you so much. I really appreciate it. If you have any technical issues or you want to suggest improvements, then you can go to the issues under my repository and post the issue here. I also have a thread in the Steam group for Better Client, which has a lot of details on what features my tweaks have, as well as future things.